You say you will take me under your wing, but I see no feathers. Are you a child of the birds, as I am of the bears? In truth, this is a relief. Your world is made with rules I have not yet memorized. I am happy to have a friend in such a place. And so the lonely babe was fed upon the wild mother's milk and cast aside from humankind. He thrived among his mother's ilk. So says the saga of Thrys. Do you know it? The wise godwolf Amira raised the child Thrys among her litter. So you see, I have good company. Thrys the wolfson, and I the bear daughter. Ask freely, my friend. Your city is far more wild than Home Forest. In Home Forest, the rules are clear. In Home Forest, your strength and speed determine your fate. Here, a tiny screech woman, no swifter than a mudworm, might confine you into a tiny cage, and one must wait for a kind stranger to grant freedom. Jarrett, wise Jarrett, taught me the bird songs of our people. If not for him, I would never have learned more than the beasts could teach me. A beast's life is to survive. A human's is to know. I am both beast and human, and so I must do both. I have learned all the bird song that Jarrett could teach. I remembered every word. These tales have brought me much pleasure. The remembering of the beasts is without lies. We know not to approach the wasp's nest because long ago, one bear mother discovered its dangers. This she taught to her cubs, and those cubs taught the next. We do not remember Rito and the Battle of the Buzzing Brutes. We remember only what is useful to us now. Rito will be forgotten. The beauty of the story will be forgotten, but the lesson will not. It is different between beasts and humans. I am lucky to enjoy both ways. He came to me when I was small, a fierce, wild one, yet unaware of the difference between the other cubs and herself. He called to me in a soft song. At first I thought him a great bird. We each reached out to the other. We found each other. Jarrett visited me often, and in time I learned his songs and more. When he built a small cabin within Home Forest, I hunted his food and fetched his water by day while he studied his books and his magics. By night, by the fire, he'd tell me tales of the world of people. Jarrett is my master and my friend, my teacher and myself. He teaches me and I care for him. I heard this was a place of many people, so here I came. I have seen more faces here in a day than I had seen in all the days of my life together. But I have not found the face I seek. Jarrett is missing. It is my duty to find him. That mystery is thick and ugly as a swarm of hornets. It started with a great disturbance in Home Forest. A terrible disease came in the night and turned the birds and beasts soft and foul as carrion while they still lived. I watched countless of my loved ones die, rotted from the inside. When I ran to Jarrett to tell him what I had seen, his reaction was strange. He had no answer. The next morning, Jarrett did not emerge from his room. I left him be, but after 3 days I grew anxious. I broke down the door and inside his chamber was nothing. His equipment, his books, all but some scraps of parchment were gone. He was kidnapped and all his research was taken with him. The only clue I found was a letter among the scraps. I could not make out all the words, but I recognized the threat. Death. Coming for you. And the signature? Attenborough. I do not know the one called Attenborough, but I know that if I am to find Jarrett, I must start there. Whoever this Attenborough may be, I believe he or she may know where Jarrett has been taken.
Assume you address me for a reason, so go on. Of course you do. I do, for they have demon blood running through their scoundrelly veins. Admittedly, unlike true demons, it is not impossible for an imp to be kind and mean it, to have intentions other than vile. But nevertheless, these scamps are never to be trusted. Their volatility is not only highly annoying, in all too many situations it can be lethal. I am not from any place. I remember them. Yes, I can see them still. Though when I try to focus on their details, like good, no use in standing about.
Ready to advance? Ready to
ask away, my friend, ask away. Always helps to know a thing or two about who's covering your back against the gnashing hordes, eh? Frankly, it surprises me you lot are so eager to work with them. In my experience, they're kinda less reliable than used wagon sales dwarfs from Yuthal Gore. Heed me, comrade. You can't trust a wizard, witch, diviner, conjurer, or seer farther than you can throw them. Come now, comrade, you ought to have better sense than to ask me why I despise the basest, cruelest, filthiest creatures in all of creation. Most of we source hunters can recall more than enough memories of the look of an orcish blade coming down between the eyes, or the cold pressure of one of their studded clubs held to the temple. In that sense, I'm no different than any other. But the difference? Well, I'll say this much. With age, one might forgive the soldiers in an enemy army, might see them as cogs in a machine, might witness the humanity within even the cruelest enemy. Even so, some acts of war are utterly unforgivable. I have memories, comrade. Memories jagged as splinters. At times, I feel them threatening to tear me apart. Aye, comrade. And they're as gruesome a relic as their name suggests. Death fuels them, and only a sorcerer would wield them. I've seen one put to use in my day. What I witnessed, well, it's been burned into my eyelids for too long now. I don't know if I'll ever forget. Well, comrade, I've been around long enough, but not that long, mind, to know that little in this world can be split categorically into light and dark. My distrust of magic is instinctive after my years as a source hunter. But I also know that, at times, using the enemy against itself is the only way to make a lick of progress. So toss your cadaver elixirs and your illusion scrolls to high heavens, comrades. As long as I don't see a hint of darkness about you, you've got nothing to fear from old Medora. It's no coincidence the Order retired me. Way back when, don't let the name fool you. In the days of I now, it's been centuries since anything more dangerous than a badger has come out of those woods. By and by, the source hunters moved out.
You call to Ulgraf. He awaits your queries. With a simple nod, the rogue seems to say,
"Shoot!"
Ulgraf sighs and pulls parchment parts out.
When I was a kid, one day, with friends, I warned I always wanted to be a source hunter,
But source hunters didn't want no. Wargraf frowns and signals,
not easy being mute. Cot was poor. Got hungry. I ain't bitter about it though. Like the rogue's life. Freedom. Unless the law gets it.
Thank you.
Eternal silence awaits you. Unending darkness.
Heh heh heh. a new penny. A stitch in time, my friends.
As good as a new penny. Into the fray once more.
what I know. Orcs leave much better crumbs than mouldy skeletons.
Why don't I feel more relieved to see so many dead orcs?
Because whatever killed them could be around any corner, and we've no idea whether to expect friend or foe.
Hang on to your socks. That's the biggest static cloud I've ever seen.
There's got to be a way to cover up the source.
Protect the bloodstone forever, dry bones.
Oh, it's the Ickle Skilly Scandal. Oh, it's the Ickle Skilly Scandal.
Suit. I'm passing on. loathes thy stench, plagues me. I lift thee, return to horn, and wear thee like a suit.
advance too slowly to sustain me. Does anybody else smell smoke?
Trying to escape? I need a bath.
God, what is that abomination?
Well, when a crab and a man love each other very much...
Thank you.
Have fun, better cargo.
Thank you.
us a new penny.
Things got pretty hairy there for a bit. I could feel the very Reaper breathing down my neck. Thank you. I know you have my back, and I very much appreciate it.
Spotted a trap.
My tricks are known throughout the land. My rhymes rhyme nicely. Understand? Billygar! Ha-ha! You wish to know of me? I am the best, can't you see? Such tricks, such rhyming. The biggest fan of the tricking, rhyming, best Billygar man. Sad sap! You stepped into my trap! If you move, this room explodes. You'll have to stay till you wither away. Your only hope's a secret button, but since moving will kill you, you can't do nothing. Is the button red? Blue? Orange? Will you find it? Will you... storange? Florange? Yeah, whatever. I am Billygar! Ha 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 ha! Don't forget, if you move from that spot, things around here will get mighty hot! Ha ha! Too bad you can't find my secret switch without moving from, where you're standing.
Bozo can get the better of you, Source Hunter. We're all doomed.
Thank you.
Interesting devices, these pygmies among pyramids. They may be small of stature, but their potential is gigantic. Deceivingly clever. It is a trait all demonic machinations share. Yes, demonic. So very obvious to the trained eye. These apparatuses have been forged among the voids of the outer realms, where the light of stars does not reach. You do well to treat them with the utmost care. Perhaps it would even be for the best if you sling them into the reaches of infinity that surround the shelter plane. Better safe than sorry. It is an uncommonly trite thing to say, but it applies to all things demon-dreamt and devised. A mouth, but do not taste. Eyes, but do not see. Ears, but do not hear. So let me state this clearly, Hunter, that you must always remember, always, that when demons are in play, you are the hunted, and that it takes stupendous cunning and strength to escape their snares. The very moment you are certain you have them in your grip, that is the moment their traps spring, and it is their grip that shatters your soul. Dueling with demons is like playing chess against an opponent with queens for pawns. They sit and grin while your pieces slip in the sweaty fear that drops from your beleaguered brow.
On the prize. Thank you.
A pirate's office. I would have expected to find something rather more exciting inside.
With the way this place is rigged, I wouldn't speak so soon.
That's what that did. Now, to find out what effect that had.
Wolbrop stops the gaze at the painting wall and pensively scratches his chin.